shove a little inspiration, shove a little spark, show the things that drew me to the stole my heart. And tell me something I don't know instead of everything I do. And look at me as if I mean something to you. Our hearts are beating while we sleep, but while we're wide awake.
They gathered at the local Mojave Community College. Why? Well, let's ask the MCP. Why are we here today, MCP? Well, that's where everyone with a GED or a high school diploma can attend 13th or 14th grade, Mr. Dixon. Yes, outstanding, MCP. And as everyone can see here, I have my MCP with me. So what do you think the class is thinking, MCP? By my calculation, Mr. Dixon, they probably would like to know why you have brought me here today. Okay. Now that's fair. That's a fair question. Does anybody you think, MCP, know what MCP stands for? Well, it stands for Master Control Program. Mr. Dixon? No, not you, MCP. I'm sorry. Forgive me, Mr. Dixon.
Sorry, John.
No worries.
I'm sorry?
First of all, you guys are going to be teachers, right?
Yes.
First thing I found out about when I was teaching, never, because I haven't taught when I was when I was learning about teaching my first couple EDU classes, is that if you're up here and it still seems silly or stupid to you, then it's something that I had to get over, because it's that kind of strange feeling inside of you. And this is kind of, man, this is stupid, it's unworthy. But if you get to the point where we're at right now, the only thing you should have left from being up here is the uncomfortable feeling of public speaking, which if you still have that feeling and trying to get out and worried and trying to focus on how to harness that, I suggest you see a good friend of mine named Charlene and take her public speaking course here. She's amazing. The first thing that we all want to do when we want to be a teacher, there's a lot of things in life. You know, man, I was around the skydive, everything is to open up a class by writing your name, right? I'm so-and-so. But I think I wanted to make it a little bit loosen everybody up a little bit, because being loose is important. You can't work with the children without being loose. You know what I mean? You got to be able to freestyle. Mm-hmm. You got to be able to make fun, take jokes, watch cartoons, pick up on things, have music in common, things that you can talk to kids about. I'm going to teach 7th or 8th grade civics. So I think knowing about modern music, investigating things kids like, and being able to just have that trustworthy thing come to you, because without trust, you're really not going to accomplish much. I read in a book about this Latino teacher in New Jersey who wrote a book called Teaching Like Your Hair Is on Fire. And he said that the most important thing, even through the book, and the book had a lot of gavel in it, was about a one-on-one trustworthy relationship. If you get a child to trust you, and you can get in that realm, then you're going to go far with that child. But you break that trust with a kid, and that's when you're going to find yourself with problems. So I figured the best way to loosen up, as always, a little pre-algebra. Anybody ready? So I want to write my name on the board. So J plus J plus D equals X. So pretty basically, what am I going to try to do here? I'm going to solve for X, right?
Right.
That's what I want to do. I want to solve for X. So since I have the information inside, I'm going to start thinking PEMDAS. I have no parentheses. I have no powers to deal with. I have no multiplication or division, but I do have addition, and I'm going to start working left to right. Since the D is first, I'm going to write this down. Alright, now I'm just going to keep working left to right. Anybody else in pre-algebra with me?
Yeah, but what do you mean the D was first?
First letter.
Because you work alphabetically. You work alphabetically, right? All my multiplication, I didn't have any. I'm down to addition and subtraction, so I'm going to work left to right, and I'm going to work alphabetically first.
We have variables with that.
That's not a real rule.
Because out of these variables, I'm going to work with the lowest one first, and the D comes before the with the two J's. And that's why it's self different.
We're factoring, actually.
So this is actually X. My name is John Joseph Dixon, but since I'm a teacher now, this is my class. I did a lot of suffering. I did a lot of sacrifice. I am in debt up my ding. And I deserve a little respect. So actually, there are two answers. And there's not very many answers in hell for a while. X equals Mr. Dixon. You all can call me Mr. Dixon. All right. The pages that I had had to do with deaf students in the classroom. I'd like everybody to just take a minute and think about hearing loss. Think about how important hearing is to you and what are the things that hearing does in your life for you. How does it add to your life? What are the favorite things you like to hear? And probably I would think music, communication. Call me if I'm wrong. Anybody else? What else do we use hearing for? Everything's a good answer. What's your name before you answer them? What's your name?
Christina
says everything. Everything. That actually, you know what? I couldn't think of any more besides entertainment, music, communication, things like that. But it's pretty important. What are the five senses then? Ricky, give me the first two. Ricky Hughes, please, up front.
Yes, sir, Mr. Dixon. Number one would be sight.
Sight.
Number two, hearing.
Okay. How about you, Crystal? The next two?
Touch.
Touching. Magic. What else, Crystal? The next one?
Speech.
Taste.
Smell.
Taste. Was that over here said taste? Give me your name.
With Ray.
Ray says taste.
Smell.
And the fifth one is smell. Thank you, Susan. All right, out of these two, what's your first name?
Claudia.
The educator and the plant in the back there.
My name's Claudia.
All right, what are the most important two, you think? Two senses.
What's the most important?
What are the most important two senses out of these five?
One, two.
One and two, that's good. Which ones? What's most important? What do you think? What's your personal breakdown? What do you think are the most important out of these five?
Smell. Sight and hearing.
Sight and hearing. Anybody else? What are the most important? What's your first name?
Chassie.
Chassie, what's the most important two to you?
It's a hard one. They're all important. Definitely sight.
I would have to say sight would be probably the most important. It's tough. Let's take a second and think about it. Just take a second and think about what are the most important two. You have to say sight and you have to say sound.
Mm-hmm. Smell.
I'd like to not taste the pizza, but I like to see it. You know what I mean? And the second would be sound. The second would definitely be sound. Alright, now take a minute and Sue, you have a question?
Yes, I do.
What's your first name?
Ray.
Ray, go ahead, Ray.
I had a friend who was deaf, and with technology and stuff through the years, she got to be able to hear, and she hated it. She loved being deaf after she could hear. She said the world was completely different, and she liked the world she was in. When she came out and could hear, she did not like it.
Amazing.
So,
you know, I asked my kids, I ran my wife past it, and it's really tough. It's like abortion and taxes. It's the kind of thing that's just in your head, and you scramble up. Like, if I had to choose, that's just demonstrable, isn't it? Having to live without either one of these in life, you would probably say is demonstrable, correct? Demonstrable meaning absolutely hard to deal with and completely huge and out of control. You can't even take control of it.
Thank you.
Yes. What's your name? Okay.
You answered my question, Mr. Dixon.
All right. So we'd have to say, everybody, that sight is probably the most important, but this is what I'm talking about. I'm talking about sound. I'm talking about hearing.